Hello dear everyone, happy Friday. Welcome to a live balcony Q&A session. I've been doing these live Q&As for a while now for my online students, my boosties, but I figured now in the middle of the year, let's do one for everyone here in the Kalida online group. Boosties, my online students, if you see this, I will be saving this live also in your students' dashboard so you can find it later. So the theme for this Q&A is whatever you would like it to be. If you happen to see this live, let me know if you have any questions about anything dance related or about life, some advice or tips. I love sharing what I've learned. Sorry, my fan just fell. For today, if there's no questions, I will be sharing a little bit of tips on fan veils, how to dance with these props. These are the latest props that I've learned in my 20 years of dance. I only have been dancing with these for a couple of years because I was always afraid of using them because they felt so clumsy. So I had trouble with fan veils for the longest, and now they are my favorite thing to dance with. And in this live, I will teach you a few basic tricks, even for advanced dancers, this sometimes helps to go back to the basics to hopefully make it easier for you to dance with them. And maybe you'll get some ideas if you already have fan veils. So one moment please, my fan just fell on the floor. Picking it up. Yes, so I already did a live session on Instagram just a few minutes ago. You can find it there. There is the more philosophical part of today's Q&A, where we talk about less is more. Why? Because less is more is the theme of this year's online classes, where we started time traveling with the stars. So the dancers from the golden era, 40s and 50s, through the 60s and 70s, that's where we are at right now, season 2. Then we'll move on to the modern legends, the stars that I have been studying with from Egypt and beyond. And then at the end of the year, the future legends. So those are the next generation of dancers that I feel inspired by, so who I want to study with next, or who I have studied with very recently. So time traveling with the stars, the whole year will follow the timeline of dancers who inspired us. And the less is more, that's where that came from, is what we've discovered or rediscovered is watching these dancers from the 40s, 50s, 60s and 70s. All of them have great skills, but what captivates us the most, or me for instance, is the simplicity, that each dancer has their own special superpower and they only use that. So they feel confident in what they know and they don't need to show everything. So the less they do even, the more interesting, the more fascinating and the more beautiful. And this also goes together with life itself. Yes, we sometimes think we have to do everything, but taking breaks helps, doing less helps, figuring out what's important, truly important to you, helps you filter out all the unnecessary things. So if you're interested in that, the philosophical part, go to Instagram. I'll post a link in the description here later. For it's about half an hour of talk. You can listen to it while you do the laundry or something, or you can just watch it. Boosties, I'll post it on Instagram also. So for here, if you like fan veils, or you don't like it, you want to like them, or you are not familiar, hi Isla, with fan veils, then this live is for you. If you have any questions about dance at all, just post them. But for now, some tips that have helped me be less intimidated by fan veils. And first of all, and this I think counts for any prop, is what to do with your hands. Yes, if you feel like, okay, my hands are stiff, I don't know what to do with them, grabbing a prop and dancing with it, what usually happens is you use too much force. So to get your hands to relax, you have to move them, and we'll do that together. So even if you're not dancing with fan veils, do this little hand warm-up for your health. So let's shake out the hands first. So this video will be more action. If you prefer to just listen, go to Instagram for the other one. So shake out. Then open, close your fingers. First quickly. And then as you start to feel tired, open and hold. Imagine you're shooting energy out of your fingers. Extend. Spread them apart, but also upwards. Yes. And now let's make fans. So I'm fanning my fingers, keeping them as straight as possible. Pinky first, only the pinky, only the ring finger. Sorry, the birds are loud. Middle finger, index finger, and thumb. And then a little bit quicker, but keep the extension. Keep the fingers long. And then we'll switch. Index finger, keep it straight for as long as you can, and then bend right at the end. If you do this exercise every day, you'll notice the extension. It visually lengthens your fingers. So if they feel like stumpy short, it may be just tension on the inside from doing things like this on your phone or working or gardening. You want to work the extension for dance, and that will help you balance out your strength actually. So let's do this again. Straighten, 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 straighten. This is one of the most effective exercises for anything with hands and props. And shake out. And now let's do the opposite. Rolling in the fingers, just the tips, just the tips, just the tips. See if all of them join. My index finger sometimes doesn't. Then the tips and the second, what's that called? The knuckles. Then roll the knuckles and the fingers. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then try to touch. You can see that? Try to touch your hand here. It may give you cramps. In Kung Fu, this is like the bear claw. And then extend your thumb. Roll in. And close. Now we have a martial arts fist. Yes. You roll in the fingers, touch here, roll in, and then the thumb goes over, closing it. Yes. Squeeze, 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 and then shake out again. Okay, now a few more fans, opposite fans. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And then try hand waves. They may be easier. Okay. Hand waves give you trouble. Let's do a mini tutorial here also. Hand straight, thumb connecting. Rounding. Just the knuckles. It's like you're drawing up a bridge. Up. So round just the tips. And pull up the fingers. Not down, but up. And then press down. Press, 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 press. Relax. Pull up. Press. Press. That's a flat hand wave, like Samya Gamal. And you can spread the fingers a bit, pushing the middle finger down, down, and let the rest float. Keeping them close together, within this plane, they can go up. And the thumb, instead of here, bring it under, as if you're rolling a little ball. That's open hand waves. Both of them really great for fan dance. Now, second part, this was fingers. And hands, the wrists, interlace your fingers, keep your arms together. I so often see this, but try this, hands together, so only the wrists can move. And circle, circle, circle. If this works, let's do 10, turn around the circle, other way. So even if you don't do fan veils, you can use this live. I'll keep it here as a hand refresher. Now change the fingers. So from here, opposite. It should feel weird. That makes it easier for your brain to connect because it's a new movement and it lubricates the joints. So if you want your joints to feel happy, you have to move them. And this is a great way to get movement between all those little bones of your hands. Okay. A couple of waves like this. Round. Press, round press, and you can even travel with that. Shake it out. Now circle the hands, circle the wrists. If you have a screen, if you circle the hands, the fingers will move, the wrists will stay. If you circle the wrists, the fingers will stay and your wrists make a circle. It's if you have an armband and you're going all the way around that. Try that out. You can also put your fingers using the bench. Let me see if you can see that. So you fixate your middle finger and then move the wrist. Usually you will make a bigger circle. You'll use more of your range if you can fixate your fingers. Try that. Using the bench. All the way down, all the way up. All the way down, all the way up. And reverse. If for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. I don't know if anyone sees this. Maybe you'll see this later. If you see this later, put replay, comment replay, so I know that you are here. Now, for fans, your grip. Your hands should feel nice and tingly now. Yes. Sorry, birds. For the grip, I'm using a bigger screen this time because most of the videos were too small. No matter if it's a fan veil or a regular fan, I recommend getting one of these or a set of Kung Fu or Tai Chi fans because they're really easy to practice opening, closing and fan movements without the silk getting in the way, and it only costs a few euros. So you can get these on Shein or I don't know the name, but for a couple of euros. So it's pretty cheap and great to practice your grip and your flutters and the opening and closing, which are the most important things. So what you want to do is to make it less is more, not grip too hard. Yes, we made a fist, now loosen. You only want to use two fingers. And you want this, the end, to be in the cup of your hand and then floating. So you don't want to grip it, you want to be able to release it. Otherwise, when the fan is open, you can see that, if you block this, it will not open. So if this is blocked here by your hand, it will not open no matter how hard you shake it. If you give it freedom, if you give this freedom, it'll open all the way. So very important how you grip it. If you grip it too tight, your hand will block it. If you can just grab the top spine, it doesn't matter if it's like this or like this. Yes, you can turn it. If you have a left and right one, hold your thumb and your index finger on one of the spines and press your thumb away. Thumb. So thumb up, like a bicycle bell, like this. Thumb up. Try to catch only one. Yes. I am gripping it tightly now, or pretty tightly now. So here, thumb up. And then let go of the rest. Only pinch here, only the first one. Let it fall by pointing this one straight up, vertical. Voila. If it doesn't open all the way, you have the wrong hand. Let me try that with the fan veils. So if you have a fan veil here, same thing. You don't want to block that. You put it horizontal. Thumb is on one side and the thumb goes up. You press up one spine and you pinch it with your index finger. So you press it up. Press it up, pinch it, let go of the rest, shake it, and you want to bring this vertical. If it does not open, it's not you, it's the other hand. Let's try that here. Give yourself the time to just work on this, yeah, to figure this out by feel. So, showing you this from all sides. I go around, my fingers are on one nail. My thumb is where the other nail is. And I press it up, 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 up. As soon as it's up and I can reach it, index finger, this is why we did this. Index finger comes up and it pinches very close. I have to go close. If I go like this, I'll be blocking the end. And I let go. Try to give space here. Yes. If you are too close, if you are too far from the end, you'll be blocking it. So you have to be pretty close to the end. Yes. And then point the spine up. See if it opens more or less completely. If it's here, that's okay. But if it's here, you've caught the other hand. So that's the less is more. Use gravity. Use less force. Just a pinch. And work smarter, not harder. If you practice just this basic skill and the flutter, you'll have all that you need, because opening and closing will give you freedom. So try it again. 1, 2, 3. Shake. Same fan, other hand. 1, 2, 3. Up. and then you close it. If you have it correctly, now you can use contact here to block it so it stays open. You want to give it freedom to open, then block it to keep it open, and you only need maybe one or two fingers. You can free up these and it will stay open 180 degrees. Very important. If it's 180 degrees, you'll have maximum silk goodness. Now to close it. This is harder to do to close it. You will use gravity again, bringing it up, 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 up. And this silk will fly. All you need to do is hold this first and free up the edge again. If you free it up, it only needs a little push. So it only needs a little flick of the wrist. If you are blocking it, if you are blocking it by holding it here, you can flick all you want. Because of the gripping, it will not close. So I am forcing it with your fingers. Doesn't work. So two ways to close a fan elegantly. One is to grip just the first spine, free up space here, and do a little flick like this, back, 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 and voila, it'll fall in itself. If you have a kung fu fan, it's even easier. You see, I let gravity do the work, and I make a little cup for the fan to fall into. I use my index finger here to let everything come together. So I'm just doing this. Open. Release that grip. Close. Open. Grip at the end when it's already open. Close. So to open, thumb is holding, I let everything go, and I just pinch, close, and work, and close, come on, showing you from all sides, you can also do like this towards you, and close, even down, then you need to. This will strengthen you a little bit. So to bring it down easier, you pinch, you let it fall, and you only have to open and to go up. So here, 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 here. It all works. Towards you to open, away from you to close. Open, close. Open, close. Open, close. And down, open, close. Try that out. I recommend getting one of these just for this. It really helps. Now with the fan. So this is not the hand. I just tried it. Switch fans. Hope this is helpful. I know I struggled so much with this. And then years later, I started doing Tai Chi. And it all made sense when we worked with these fans. Because the silk is not in the way. You can really get clear on how to open close. So this one, silk, grabbing the first spine, opening, and then even if your fan only opens to here, all you need to do is point it up. Hope you can see that. If your fan doesn't open completely, point it up. Use gravity and it will open because of the weight of the silk. So you don't have to fight it. You just find a way in your dance to bring it up. And to close it upwards, I have to be careful with my coffee. I'll go further away so you can see better. It's raining, so I can't go too far. Open, close, open, close, open, close. That's it, five times on each side. Just simple opening closing. It's a bit meditative, yes? And you get to know your fans. This one, I'm a lefty, is a lot more loose than the right. Five times. If you open and close your fans 10 times each day, it'll loosen the nail a bit and it will flow more easily. So if your fans are a bit rough, just opening and closing them and ironing them, that will help. If your fan becomes too loose, like this, see the nail, it has too much space, all you do is you just hit it on something hard or use a hammer carefully and just hammer it a bit more close, and then it will be a bit more grippy again. See this here? When the nail starts to stick out too much, that's when the fan becomes a little bit too loose. So there. You can also use your other fan if you have nothing else, MacGyver it. Like this, and you... Now it's a bit tighter, and it works better. So, those are my tips for gripping, opening and closing your fans. Another tip that I like a lot is to use your body movement and not just your hands whenever you work with props. I'll show you one little move that you can do to practice fan flutters. So you open them and start with the flutter in front of you, this one. If you flutter like this, it's very tempting to work with your whole arm. If you're here, you can do nothing except rotate, pushing the fan away from you and towards you, and everything else stays in place. So I'm using the lower arm rotation, and it's a beautiful move. Yes, you can bring it up, lower, you can have one behind and one in front, like this. So my pinky's in front, thumb is behind, pinky's in front, and you can make a little fan sandwich, like that, and then you can open, Once you have this one, you also do double. This can happen. If this happens, bring the fan up a bit, grab your pinky again. So no stress, don't struggle. You can try this, or you can just bring it up slightly when you're dancing and move with it. Yes. Once you have this one, open your arms and try to do the exact same thing. Only rotate your lower arm. So this is not moving. I'm not doing this, only the lower arm. Once you have that, flip up and start pushing front. If that works, flip in front and go up. It's my favorite because you can do it really slow. Up. And it works 3D, yes? And you can bring one arm up. Get him up. I'm just moving my body. I'm not even moving my arms. I'm tilting my ribcage. I'm pointing up and draw them down. Up, down. Now close. Bring them here and flip the wrists. And open. Here. Close. Now only one. Open. Two. Close. Open the other. Two. Close. Bring the hands back, fingers back. And down. Shoulder. Flip up. Wave. And try it again. Let the fans open. And keeping them here. Easy peasy. Little turn. Wave. And back to this one. Close. So there's a little bit of fan will flow for my boosies or those who watch who can already do fan. So if you can work with opening closing and you get used to it, you can also start experimenting from opening with just your hands when the fans are down. So that's a bit more tricky than working with gravity. That will enable you to open them while you are turning in any direction. So make it slow. The slower you open and close, the more you can use that as a flow. I have to keep my fans up, it's raining. So very slow. While you're moving close and while you're moving, open when you feel that the silk is coming down. Down, and silk goes up, you can close. This way I will not see a lot of struggling to open and struggling to close. Play with it. feel when it's easy to open. And if you're spinning a long time, you can use your hands. If you're spinning like this, use your hands, feel them open. And it will look like magic. You don't see when it's opening. And to close them, use your fingers. Voila. So that's my tip. If you do nothing else, work on opening and closing and playing with it. And second move, flutters. Practicing this rotation, then here, and here. And once you have those two, all the rest will be easy peasy. Then you'll have what you need for fanbells basics. Hope this works. If you want to do more with props and you're not a Boosty member yet, not an online student, I will be teaching only online this year. As I was saying in Instagram, I'm not teaching or traveling for teaching this year yet. So, but you can still find all of my props classes from last year, strength, flexibility, and dance. Boost 2023 was only about props, and this third season, that's I think 12 weeks of classes, was all about fanbills. So if you want to learn fanbills, become a Boosty, just put Boost in the comments and I'll send you the link. You will have access for a full year to all of the classes of this year, Time Traveling with the Stars, and all the props videos, plus my fanbills DVD. So it's all in there. Also these lives, I will put them on there. Boosties, we have a break right now, but on Tuesday we'll be back with the next live classes. So that's it from me. Hope this was useful. Let me know if you have any other topics that you would like to have a live about. I'll do these a couple of times per year, maybe in winter another one. Yes. Also let me know what you are up to, because I haven't seen a lot of you live anymore. This weekend we'll be having just a quiet weekend. It's a bank holiday. On Monday it's Pinkster, they call it in Belgium. So let me know what you'll be up to this weekend, and I hope you enjoy. Bye bye. Cheers. We'll see you Tuesday.